One championship fight. You can see the size of the man. You can expect that he can unleash some big power. And this is the prospect that Aung La N Sang faces.
Yeah, Aung La N Sang wasted no time immediately getting this fight to the ground. We saw in Butorin's last one after that devastating knockout of Leandro Ataides. So it is dangerous to stand and bang with this Butorin banger. Good up kicks off the back, trying to be careful so Butorin doesn't jump in on him. Big heavy leg kicks coming from the downed opponent as well.
Defending well, actually, Aung, from that position. Not really giving Butorin much daylight to do anything particularly damaging, although it looks vulnerable, doesn't it?
Yeah, Butorin's just so strong. Look at this. It's hard for him to even, Aung La N Sang can't keep him off of him.
Even those arm punches of Butorin will pack some power. Doesn't even need to put any shoulder or body behind that. Such big arms. In those wide arcs, they can do some damage. But at the moment, he can't really get within punching distance, not to Aung La N Sang's head anyway.
Aung La N Sang is a very, very accomplished grappler. It's dangerous for Butorin to play this game. He should let Aung La N Sang back up and start banging with him.
When you see your opponent prostrate on the ground there, you immediately think to yourself, well, I could be in an advantage here. The technical ground kick is an option. He landed a big, heavy right hand there that did connect.
What a technical ground kick attempt there. But Aung La N Sang is able to use that ankle lock attempt to possibly sweep and get on top. But now they're kind of playing that 50-50 leg lock position.
Who will fade first?
Yeah, this is a dangerous game to play. Those knees are so delicate when you start twisting and pulling and scrambling like this.
It's also a question of who's got the longer arms, although Butorin there uses that left leg of his, which is free, to do some damage. But he's also getting in that right hand in the hammer blow fashion to the right side of Aung La N Sang's face.
He's actually able to use that 50-50 position to get back up to his feet, and now Butorin's the one on his back.
Something of a reversal.
It's a really slow-moving sweep, but he was able to reverse the position, and now Aung La N Sang is on top.
Being hugged in nice and close by the Russian, though, just breaking down that space, limiting the work that the Burmese fighter can manage, although he's just trying to squeeze out of it, and he got caught with that right hand from the Russian.
Butorin is a big, heavy stand-up fighter, but he is a professional mixed martial artist, so he knows he's very comfortable off his back. But here he's got to turn, he's got to create some space, he's got to push the Python away.
Aung La N Sang at times just burying his face inside into his opponent's face just so that he can get some leverage, keep his head pinned down. You can do quite a lot of work with your head. Move your opponent's head to one side, pin it down to the canvas.
Easily slices through the guard like a hot knife through butter as he easily just passes into side control. Now he's got neon belly, and he might choose to either go into full mount or he's just choosing to stay in side control. Now the possible submissions from side control aren't as many as, being in full mount, but he's still got a lot of ground and pound that he can do.
So popular in his home country of Myanmar, but spends his days in the eastern part of the United States, in Maryland, Aung La N Sang.
Butorin just uses strength to just throw Aung La N Sang off of him.
Oh, and he caught him with a technical ground kick. Now he comes down with a ground and pound. More ground kicks and another one on both sides of the head, both feet being used. And this is a good moment for Butorin to catch the judge's eyes, the referee looking carefully to see if Aung La N Sang is ready to give up. He's certainly taking some punishment, but he looks composed.
Butorin's got to be careful not to gas himself out. All that muscle eats up a lot of oxygen, and when you throw every single thing into each one of those shots, your energy is going to drop dramatically quick.
Taking full advantage of the one championship rules, I can't remember a contest where I've seen so many technical ground kicks being thrown by either man, but Butorin certainly is making the most of the opportunity, with Aung La N Sang spending so much of this contest on his back.
Lots of ground and pound from Butorin, but Aung La N Sang
has impressed everyone in the One Championship setup, and there was an event in his home country of Myanmar earlier this year. There's set to be another one before the year is out, and I'm sure he's looking at the prospect of perhaps challenging for that world title in his home country. What an event that would be. He's got to, first of all, avoid those uppercuts off Butorin if he's going to get any further, though. He says, no, you're not hurting me with those. I've got some punches of my own. We didn't see much by way of stand-up in the first round, but it looks as if it might be the way this one takes shape in the second match.
Aung La N Sang is kind of taunting Butorin. He's trying to get him to engage. He's shaking his fingers at him. He's saying, no, you ain't got nothing. Bring it. And that's going to, you know, kind of make you a little bit frustrated, and that emotion is going to translate into energy expenditure. He's got to keep a cool head about him.
Aung La N Sang, as you can see, likes to throw single punches. He's not a big combination puncher. These single blows, though, are heavy. He makes them count. He took a punch there. It was a glancing blow in the end. Got on the end of a ramrod left jab from Butorin as Aung La N Sang came in. These are heavy blows they're exchanging.
Yeah, Butorin's throwing big shots, but they're sloppy shots. He's kind of lunging in. He seems like he's completely gassed
already.
He does
look tired now, doesn't he?
Mouth is wide open,
second
sucking
round.
Wind. And there's nothing more demoralizing than realizing halfway through the fight your energy is done.
And you can see that Aung La N Sang, or was at least, could still be setting himself up for that knee to the middle of the body. He sent one in already, and if Butorin really is gassed...
That's an arm triangle, Steve. That's
over. Just take us through exactly what that submission move was, Mitch. It was hard to see it coming.
Yeah, you could see him kind of setting it up, but Butorin had his arm trapped up next to his head and essentially the arm triangle, and you could see him press him up against the cage here, and Butorin just concedes defeat, and as soon as it's in, he immediately taps and realizes.
以降服方式获胜的是 红方选手 Aung La N Sang!
What a prospect, Mitch, to see Aung La N Sang challenge for the title, perhaps in his home country history, that would be.
That would be an amazing matchup. Big Dash against Aung La N Sang in Myanmar for the world middleweight title. I can't wait. If it happens, I don't want to get ahead of myself, but a truly tremendous display by Aung La N Sang here tonight.